For ECS, as a development organization, we have always grappled with this idea of development in a context where urban populations are migrating into the rural areas. Besides everything else, for farmers, food security is a primary concern. And that is one of the reasons we found that they were trapped with this whole Jhum mindset, where if they did not do Jhum, then they felt that they were left out.
Amakan hisapra postiti Jhum khiti kora to hoy traditional kam ase hoyli bi tati bishi loss pai kam kora bishi kharcha jay aro production do hoyli komti.
The organization took up SRI as an intervention point in Longra, where NABARD came in with their support for the first year to actually introduce the SRI concept.
Poila do hoyle SRI nakura time de normal khiti kora time de to hoyle ekta cluster de 5 dina bhilai thakisi hoyli bi ite to same size de ek dina bijundu bhilai aro production do itui pishi.
In the first year after the harvest was done, when they went back and they found that the crop had at least increased by almost 10 to 15%, the community sat together and the village council made a resolution that every farmer would adopt SRI as a way of doing wet terracing. Into the fourth year, we found that the production had actually doubled. So when we look into the church barn, there was, in the first year, there was only 800 tins, and later on we found that it had gone up to 1700 tins, so it had more than doubled.
With the help of ECS, it was 2015 there, 300 tin, or 16 there, another 300, 600.
In today's modern time, there is also the need for cash. And so there were two things which was very prominent. One was the oranges, and the other one, the practice of turning sugarcane juice into molasses. KVK was the organization which came in to give us the technical support, and we introduced a new breed of sugarcane. And in some homes, you know, families even producing up to 80,000, 90,000. And so this extra income started coming into the community. It was, you know, meeting many of the other needs which otherwise was not being met.
Sugar cane timing do hoile school admission kura time de pachakan nimire boisa postide tusara jaga bra ko income nai hoile bi itu thik season de sugar cane do banai.
The pressure on the Jhum was becoming more and more, and so the idea of augmenting Jhum and getting into horticulture as another income source, in a sense the citrus Jhum plot was actually, you know, emanating some of those elements where you had multiple crops. And in the first year itself, the farmers started producing bananas. Secondly, there was a lot of risk involved in Jhum because of the present climate change where rains are, you know, so uncertain. And they began to realize that the harvest was very unpredictable. And so gradually, by the fourth year, the community got together and they said, we are going to give up Jhum.
Dubra itiado pa soka khiti do charity bo gana posti manukhan idu sal to Luton Kitty Catule Pitiana, you know, going in a console for Panikiti Gurule, yes.
I remember when ECS started off this work, we had moments when there were epidemics in the village where people would just be in their beds and no one would be working. And so ECS started working on health as well. And our primary focus was on mother and child care. We began to realize that one third of the money was actually going into buying medicine. And we realized that much of it, you know, the expenses incurred was actually because of lack of sanitation. If we deal with sanitation and if the open defecation is controlled, then 50% of the problem would be solved. Tata has put in around 40% of the cost. The community put in 60% of the cost. And today, every home has a proper toilet, which is a double pit toilet with a junction box. If our programs were successful, it was because the village council was open to change. Then the church, because the church was driven towards development and not being just caught up in spiritual, you know, affairs of the church members, but to really see that, you know, communities are enhancing. If we just take on the community in confidence and take them into the planning process, and if governments can come together and take advantage of the strength of communities coming and working together, that I feel is the way forward for sustainable development.